Starting off our list at number 10 is Halle Berry. She's a very successful actress who even won an Oscar for her role in the movie Monsters Ball. But it seems she has struggled to regain that fame ever since she played Storm in the X-Men movies. It's clear the woman can act, we cannot take that from her. But it all came crashing down when she took on the lead role in Catwoman, which was loosely based off the DC female superhero. You would think this role could be the start to her earning a spot in the superhero franchise, but instead, the movie was a complete flop. And when you're playing Catwoman in the movie Catwoman, you can't really blame anyone else. The movie was so bad it appeared on Roger Ebert's list of most hated films, and her performance earned a Razzie back in 2005. The movie got 9% on Rotten Tomatoes, and it didn't even break even at the box office. The budget movie was $100 million, and it only made back $82.1 million. She received a lot of negative critiques and reviews for her performance, but she had no problem dissing Warner Brothers in her acceptance speech for her Razzie. She thanked them for, and I quote, "Thanks for putting me in a piece of shit, god-awful movie. It was just what my career needed." I think it's safe to say Marvel won't be in any rush to hire her for any of their superhero roles. Starting off our list at number 10 is Leonardo DiCaprio. The incredibly successful actor had meetings to discuss taking the role of Robin in Batman Forever, and also the role of Spider-Man when Sam Raimi launched the franchise. The conclusions of the meetings? Apparently he turned down both of the roles. During an interview with the shortlist back in 2016, Leo was asked if he actually wanted the role as Robin, to which Leo replied, and I quote, "I don't think I did, no. As I recall, I took the meeting but didn't want to play the role." The movie didn't end up receiving very good ratings, so the interviewer asked him if he felt he dodged a bullet, and he had nothing to say, he just laughed. He went on to speak about the Spider-Man role, and he said it was a similar situation to the Robin role. He turned down the role because he didn't want it at the time. I mean, once people keep coming to you to take on their superhero roles and you keep denying them, eventually they are going to stop. And it looks like they did. He has yet to take on another superhero meeting ever since. Starting off our list at number 10 is Jason Statham. It came to be a surprise for a lot of people when articles surfaced that Jason had turned down a major role in the MCU. The articles never mentioned which role it was that he turned down, but just that the reasoning was a schedule conflict. The president of Marvel, Kevin Feige, reported that they've asked for the actor in the past, even before this offer, but nothing ever seemed to work out. He also said that Jason was polite about it and said, "Sorry it didn't work out, maybe next time." This was surprising to hear for a lot of people, because reports later on surfaced about the actor slamming Marvel and all other superhero movies in general. When rumors started that he was going to play the villain in the upcoming second season of Daredevil, he responded by saying, and I quote, "I could take my grandma and put her in a cape and then put her in a green screen and then have stunt doubles come in and do all the action. Anybody can do it." He also went on to say that he has no ambition to do modern action films like Marvel. So Jason must be a really good actor then when he was telling Kevin Feige, maybe next time. Starting off our list at number 10 is Jennifer Garner. She's had a very successful career, but there's one movie that was a huge miss, Elektra, which came out back in 2005. It was a spin-off of the movie Daredevil, which was actually profitable, but this movie bombed at the box office harder than anyone expected. Some people said that it killed the idea of a female-led superhero movie, similarly to 2004's Catwoman movie. Garner, being the sweet soul that she is, never badmouthed Marvel or said anything negative about her filming experience. It was her now ex-boyfriend Michael Vartan that let the truth slip. Just a few weeks after the movie's release, he told Us Weekly that she called him and said the movie was awful and that she had to do it because of her contract, which was actually signed before the release of Daredevil. Not only was the box office bomb a reason to not hire her again, but she also got caught talking smack. At number 9 we have Mickey Rourke. You might know him as Whiplash, the villain from Marvel's Iron Man 2. The movie was reviewed as decent but not as good as the first film, and Mickey was one to agree with that. He had no problem trashing both the movie and Marvel Studios, saying that he was disappointed with the final version of the movie. When he was interviewed by Seth Meyers, he stated, "I'm not a Marvel fan. Once I did a movie for Marvel and they cut the whole goddamn thing out." Apparently the real reason for his hatred is because the creative team reduced his character in the film drastically. Mickey wanted to add layers to his character, but in the end Marvel decided to simplify the villain, having him just be evil for the sake of being evil. Marvel. He went on to give a final statement saying, "If Marvel wants to make mindless comic book movies, then I don't want to be a part of it." Yeah, that will definitely have you blacklisted from Marvel Studios. At number 9, we have Andrew Garfield, who we know played the iconic Spider-Man hero at one point in time. Most people thought he did a good job, but the internet has also titled him as the least relevant Spider-Man actor. Sony had big plans for Mark Webb's amazing Spider-Man franchise, but that all ended when Marvel got the rights to Spider-Man. Not long after the rights were gained by Marvel, two Amazing Spider-Man sequels were cancelled and the role of Spidey was recast for his appearance in Captain America: Civil War. Yep, Garfield was out of his superhero role. There's no definite reason as to why Marvel didn't keep him for the role, but most people are thinking they wanted to leave the Sony legacy behind and start fresh with their own. If they really liked him as Spider-Man, they definitely would have just continued with him. I think they made it pretty clear by canceling his two sequels and finding a new actor. At number 9 is Emily Blunt. This successful actress would never get denied by Marvel based on her talent, but she probably won't be offered any more roles after denying her last two. That's right, she has said no to Marvel not just once, but twice. This Devil Wears Prada actress was actually the original choice for Black Widow, but Emily turned down the part. She might be regretting that now after seeing all the movies the hero character has been in, and has now been confirmed to have her own hero film coming. She was also offered the role of Peggy Carter in the first Avenger. Fox reports say that they had her under a contract for a film of their choosing, and it was Gulliver's Travel that kept her from showing up for Iron Man 2. The schedules had conflicts and she turned down yet another role. Back in 2012, during an interview with Vulture, she was asked if she would ever consider doing a superhero movie, and she said she was open to any genre, but stated, and I quote, "Usually the female parts in the superhero film feel thankless. She's the pill girlfriend while the guys are whizzing around saving the world. So I guess she would want a hero-only part, and one that is kicking some serious butt. Who knows, maybe Marvel will be forgiving and try her again one day, although they've been turned down twice already, so it appears they've moved on." In at number 9, we have Christopher Eccleston. The actor took on the lead villain, Dark Elf Malekith, in Thor: The Dark World. The role seems like it would be anyone's dream, but the actor has been very open about how much he hated working on the movie. He told BBC Radio 2 that he took on the role for the money, but soon regretted it. He went on to say, and I quote, "Marvel was dishonest to me because they never ever let me know that there'd be that amount of makeup." The actor explained that his makeup process was 7 to 8 hours a day, which would begin at 4 a.m. He said it would be a full day of work just to get his makeup done. During an interview with Digital Spy, he said the only reason he even took the role was for the money, and to him, that wasn't even worth it. Swiping the number 8 spot is January Jones, known for her role as Emma Frost in X-Men First Class. While some fans praised her performance, critics and also some of her co-stars says she seduced the audience but left them feeling numb. Reviewers of the film said her delivery of the character was wooden. Various actors who have worked with her also went on to say that the actress is rude and unapproachable. The star's bad reputation in the industry has made various headlines, all confirming that she isn't the easiest person to work with. Some headlines have gone as far as labeling her as a homewrecker. An article by thedailymail.com says the actress has an inside joke with fellow X-Men alum James Marsden, teasing that he is the father of her son. Fans and other co-stars don't seem to get the joke and aren't too thrilled with her behavior. I'm sure with a reputation and a performance like that, Marvel won't be knocking on her door anytime soon. Taking the number 8 spot is Shailene Woodley, the actress best known for her roles in Fault in Our Stars and the movie series Divergent. One role people don't know about is that she actually got to play the role as Mary Jane Watson in The Amazing Spider-Man 2. She was casted for the role and even filmed all of her scenes. However, during post-production, Woodley's scenes ended up being cut from the movie. Marvel ended up snatching up Spider-Man from Sony, but Woodley was no longer playing Mary Jane. As the franchise went on, Marvel has never asked her to come back as Mary Jane, nor have they offered her any other role. And one can only guess why. Sliding into number 8, we have Will Smith, another actor who turned down a great opportunity, but in the DC universe. Apparently, he was the first black hero who was considered to play Superman in Superman Returns. Turns out he didn't take the role because of the criticism he faced after portraying the traditionally white hero of Wild Wild West. I can totally understand why you might be more hesitant to take it, but man, how can you turn down becoming the first black Superman? That's iconic. This would give Will the chance to star in a Marvel movie since he didn't take on the DC role, but how could they offer him something bigger than that? If he didn't take an offer like that, what would he take. It also doesn't help his case that he recently announced that he would be leaving the Suicide Squad series and won't be returning for the sequel. Will Smith and his reps refused to comment on the matter, but some sources have said it's due to scheduling conflicts. The actor isn't painting a very good picture for Marvel when it comes to being reliable or even interested for that matter. Sliding into number 8, we have Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen. I think they count as one because they go hand in hand. The Olsen twins is what actually gave them their acting career. They've had a very successful acting career ever since they booked their first role on Full House when they were just infants. They continue to act, write books, create a fashion line, and became millionaires by the time they were 18 years old. Their last movie together though was New York Minute back in 2004. Unfortunately, the movie didn't impress the media and received some harsh critics and reviews. Some said the movie sexualized the twins, who were only 17 years old while filming it. It received a 4 out of 10 star rating and only 11% on Rotten Tomatoes. It didn't do very well at the box office either. Ashley has told People magazine she lost her passion for acting. The two were wanted for the spinoff of Full House, but Ashley said, I quote, "I have not been in front of a camera since I was 17 and I don't feel comfortable acting." Their focus is now on fashion as they run a very successful career in the fashion world. Their little sister Elizabeth Olsen has stolen the acting spotlight in the Marvel franchise instead. In the number 7 spot we have Wesley Snipes. He has been one of the most in-demand action stars because of his incredible ability to combine athletic and martial arts skills. However, his career started to lose steam when Snipes began to claim that Hollywood had a race issue. He's had various run-ins with the law to a point of being arrested and sentenced to 3 years in prison for tax return conviction, and has also had some unsuccessful movie roles. It wasn't until his role in Blade that his career jump-started again. It's said that he earned the film $131 million worldwide, but the success went cold when Blade Trinity was titled as the worst film in the franchise. Snipes began to claim different encounters with racism and disrespect on set. His co-star Patton Oswalt called the film a very troubled production, saying that they had problems with Snipes' behavior while shooting. Apparently, Snipes was demanding that the director David Goyer quit. Yeah, not the type of person you really want to work with. Marvel has a lot of other options to go with, so I think they're good. At number 7, we have Jensen Ackles, the Hollywood heartthrob from the TV series Supernatural. Back when Marvel was casting for Avengers, Ackles was one of many actors who auditioned for the role of Captain America. Obviously, he didn't get the role, and apparently he wasn't happy about it. Reports say that the actor took it pretty hard and was one to hold a grudge. Later on, Marvel came to him with the offer to play Hawkeye, but he refused, stating that he had scheduling conflicts with Supernatural. No one was buying that excuse because no conflicts appeared when he auditioned for Captain America while filming a show. Reports went on to say that his reasoning was questionable because his schedule clearly allowed him to take on the role as Captain America if he would have gotten it. But he missed out on the role as Hawkeye and the role went to Jeremy Renner instead. He probably felt it was a consolation prize from Marvel and his ego wouldn't let him take it. That's probably the last offer Marvel will give him too, since he wasn't one to politely decline. Taking the number 7 spot is Matt Damon. If you remember the 2003 movie Daredevil, which was titled a flop, apparently Matt dodged a bullet by turning down the role for it. Daredevil is another Marvel Comics property that ended up with Fox at some point during its development, but stems from the original Marvel Comics. Buddy actors Matt Damon and Ben Affleck were both huge fans of Daredevil. Matt even described Matt Murdock as their favorite superhero. Turns out that Matt was offered the part for Daredevil, which was a pretty tempting deal at first, but when he was approached with the project, he said he wasn't impressed with the script. Some couldn't believe he turned down a role from his favorite comics, but he said during an interview that he tried to divorce his emotion from it. It's just another actor who is denying a Marvel role and one that isn't his favorite comic. What else can Marvel offer for him if he's willing to deny that? Although, with the movie mostly being remembered as bad, it was probably a blessing in disguise. Taking the number 7 spot is Alan Cumming, the actor who took on the role as Nightcrawler in X2 X-Men United. The movie is considered one of the best superhero movies ever, and one of its major highlights was Cumming's performance. Unfortunately, he never reprised the role, and it was most likely because of his relationship with the director, Bryan Singer. When he was asked about X-Men 3, he had no problem admitting that he wasn't upset that Singer wouldn't be directing it. He went on to say that he didn't enjoy working with him on X2. Rumors began to spread that he would be making a return in X-Men Days of Future Past, but he later clarified that he was never contacted about it and he wasn't too happy about that. At number 6 we have Jessica Chastain, who made fans go crazy when she said no to joining the MCU back in 2012 for a role in the Iron Man movie. However, it caused a ton of buzz when it was was announced that she would be joining Iron Man 3 as a scientist. People were going crazy with excitement that she would be making her way into the Iron Man franchise, but a lot of dreams were shattered when Chastain spoke about it on Facebook. She wrote, "Sorry to say that Iron Man 3 isn't going to work out. My schedule is jam-packed and I can't fit anything else in. The press announced my possible attachment far too soon. I know many of you wanted me to be involved and I'm so sorry to disappoint you." It was a nice apology, but also caused some controversy for the actress. She did leave the door open for MCU and said she hopes there will be another Marvel film for her in the future. It's hard to believe that Marvel would want to cast her after she pulled away from a role like that, especially because it had created so much buzz already. Sliding into number 6, we have Armie Hammer, an actor who has been rumored for a number of different superhero roles. All of those rumored roles were in the DCEU. He has never actually appeared in any comic book movie adaptation, DCEU, or the MCU. Marvel hasn't expressed any interest, or at least any that we can find on the internet. Fans have wondered why he hasn't actually gone past the rumored roles and actually booked any. It's no surprise that rumored roles often get back to the casting director and production team, but apparently not enough to spark an actual interest for him playing the part. It might have to do with his reputation, as he's known for having no sense of impulse control when it comes to his social media, Twitter especially. He has no problem voicing his opinions, and his rash reactions have made him the center of attention, but not in a good way. He ended up deleting his Twitter account after a web portal aired all of his dirty laundry. So maybe Marvel did hear about the rumors for the roles, but didn't pursue him for the part because of his very unprofessional reputation. In at number 6, we have Ben Affleck, the runner-up to Matt Damon, who took the role of Daredevil after Damon denied it. In 2003, after Marvel's Daredevil movie hit the screens, nothing for Ben was ever the same. The movie is famously known to be bad and received a variety of bad reviews from critics. Fans have said that it is a movie that had the biggest impact on Ben's career, and not in a positive way. The worst part? Ben agrees. In 2015, during an interview with New York Times Daily, he told the interviewer that he hates Daredevil and it would have saved him a lot of embarrassment if his buddy Matt Damon would have accepted the role first. The movie has always followed him throughout his acting career, he said. Apparently, when he was hired to play Batman in Batman vs. Superman, his poor performance as Daredevil was brought up several times. He still blames the movie for hurting his acting career and isn't eager to jump back into Marvel ever again. I think it's safe to say that he had his run with them, and the feeling is probably mutual. At number 6, we have Kirsten Dunst. She's known for her role in a variety of movies, but no one can forget her team up with Tobey Maguire in the Spider-Man movies. It's often said that there has been a lot of Spider-Man movies made over the years, and apparently Dunst isn't too thrilled about it. She has no problem voicing her opinion lately that nothing can top the films they made and that their attempts are just money grabs. She says in an interview with Marie Claire, and I quote, "We made the best one, so who cares? I'm like, you can make all you want. They're just milking that cow for money and it's so obvious." Sounds like someone is a little bitter. The new Spider-Man, Tom Holland, responded to her comments by saying, "You know, she's entitled to her own opinion and I'm not one to judge at all. I definitely am not doing this movie for the money. I mean, it's a job that I think anyone would do regardless of what you're getting paid." Well said, Tom, and you're probably right. That's why you're in the MCU and Kirsten won't ever be welcomed back. Halfway through the list at number 5, we have Tobey Maguire, also known as the original Spider-Man for my generation. He rose to stardom when the Spider-Man franchise began and was very successful almost immediately. But the third film is what stunted his chances of reaching the top. After the third movie came out, it received a lot of negative critiques and reviews, some being for Tobey's performance. It wasn't all his fault though. The director Sam Raimi said, and I quote, "It's a movie that just didn't work very well. I tried to make it work, but I didn't really believe in all the characters, so that couldn't be hidden from people who loved Spider-Man." When the director admits that the movie was bad, the movie was bad. During the third movie, Tobey found himself in some trouble with the law regarding an illegal gambling issue. Turns out he was illegally gambling and won $311,000, which he had no legal rights for. It was revealed that he also tried to gamble when it came to his work. Apparently, with Spider-Man 2, he was playing hardball trying to get a better contract when it came to filming future sequels. Sony executives were aware and threatened to replace him with Jake Gyllenhaal. Definitely not something you should use your illegal gambling skills on, and I'm sure Marvel doesn't even have time for those kinds of games. The franchise did a reboot and a new Spider-Man was casted for a reason. Let's be honest. Halfway through our list at number 5 is Eliza Dushku, the actress who is best known for her role in Buffy the Vampire Slayer and its spin-off series Angel. Back when Marvel announced the Black Widow would be appearing in Iron Man 2, a number of actresses were rumored for the role. But there was one actress who went completely out of her way to launch a full-on internet campaign for the part, and that actress was Eliza. She began campaigning very early on and was receiving a lot of support and interest from fans for her campaign. A lot of people were expecting her to land the role because of it. Apparently, the people she wanted to be interested in her campaign weren't, those people being Marvel. Reports say that there has been many opportunities to cast her for roles, but she has never even been given the chance. People have said that there was no way Marvel didn't see her campaign, as it received an overwhelming amount of attention and interest. It just didn't receive any from them, and never has. Halfway through the list at number 5, we have Kristen Stewart, also known as Bella from Twilight. She is one of many actresses who have come out and said that she'd be more than happy to take a role in the MCU. In one of her interviews, she stated that she would love to appear next to Captain America and show the world she can do more than just Bella Swan in the Twilight series. But shockingly, MCU fans weren't enthused in the slightest at the idea of her possibly joining their beloved superhero universe one day. Fans have no problem stating online that she's nowhere near ready or worthy for a gig in the MCU. It doesn't help her case that she was offered a role already in the DC movie Man of Steel as Lois Lane, but she turned it down. According to the New York Daily News, Kristen had a meeting to discuss the role of playing Superman's love interest, but apparently the meeting didn't last very long. Turns out she claimed she had no desire to jump into another franchise even though Twilight was over. So maybe she's just all talk when she said she would be more than happy to take on a role, because guess what, Kristen, the MCU is also a franchise, and one you're probably not ready for. And don't think people have forgotten about her cheating scandal with the director Rupert Sanders from one of her previous movies. People don't forget a reputation like that, especially when it involves the acting industry. Halfway through our list at number 5, we have Jenna Elfman. The American actress wouldn't not be hired because of her lack of talent. She definitely has a successful career. The one thing holding her back though is her strong connection to Scientology. Not only is she a member of the church, but she strongly advocates for it. In January 2005, she stated in a magazine, I quote, "I intend to make Scientology as accessible to as many people as I can." She went on to say that it was her duty to clear the planet using Scientology methods. She also appeared at the ribbon cutting ceremony at the opening of the Church of Scientology in Nashville in 2009. Just last year, she did an interview with People talking about her 28-year relationship with Scientology. As we know, the religion faces a lot of criticism in the industry. People have openly admitted they won't work with certain actors because they are tied to the controversial religion. Her response to the criticism is, "I think that anything that works tends to get attacked." She is clearly sticking to her faith, which will probably continue to keep her out of the Marvel Universe. They don't need or want controversy like that. Sliding into the number 4 spot is Edward Norton. A lot of Marvel fans are already aware of his battle when it came to writing the script for The Incredible Hulk. The movie itself turned out okay, but the filming process was apparently a chaotic mess. The actor originally turned down the role as the angry green giant, but later on accepted it on the assumption that any changes he made to the original screenplay would be included in the final cut. However, he heavily re-edited it, and it was chaos trying to combine it with Zach Penn's original writing. Although fans may have liked the movie, it's been reported that Marvel hates it. Okay, maybe not hates, because I know that's a really strong word, but they weren't happy with it. This led them to replace Norton with Mark Ruffalo when it came time to film The Avengers. The studio even issued a statement regarding the new casting announcement and said they preferred an actor, and I quote, "who embodies the creative and collaborative spirit as our other talented cast members." The director of The Incredible Hulk, Louis Leterrier, told Entertainment Weekly that Marvel and Norton didn't come to an agreement where we could have all worked together. Well, at least they tried, right? At number 4, we have Joaquin Phoenix. The actor has a list of different movies on his successful resume, but none of them being a Marvel movie. This isn't because of a lack of opportunity either. It turns out he's had plenty of opportunity to star in the MCU. It was no secret at the time that Marvel wanted Joaquin for the role of Doctor Strange, and not just to have a meeting for the role, it was actually offered to him. During an interview with Time Out London, he told them that he turned down down the role because he didn't see his sensibilities meshing well with big tentpole franchise universe building. He then went on to say that the franchise, in quotes, has gotten better. He admitted, "I flirted with several of those films, having meetings and getting close, but ultimately it never felt like they'd really be fulfilling." Ouch, that must have been hard for Marvel to hear. I think it was easier to move on from the idea of having him a part of the MCU after hearing that. No one wants to hire someone who doesn't see an MCU role as fulfilling, which is crazy to me because a role like that is a dream come true to 99% of the world's population. Coming in at number 4, we have Mel Gibson, once a very respected and successful actor, but one that is now known for being in scandalous and illegal activities. The actor has had no problem sharing pretty harsh words and has gotten in trouble with the law on a number of occasions. Needless to say, he's not exactly the most popular casting choice right now, especially for Marvel. For starters, I don't think family-friendly Disney would ever want someone like Mel Gibson representing the MCU. And turns out he was already offered a role back in the day and turned it down. He was offered to play the role of Odin in Thor, which is Thor's dad, but he turned it down with no reason at all, simply that he didn't want to do it. And like many other words, he has no problem saying it how it is. During an interview when he was asked about being offered a role in the superhero movie, he said, and I quote, "Yeah, long time ago to play Thor's dad, but I didn't do it." He went on to say that he had no interest, and Marvel probably sees that as a blessing with Mel's awful new reputation he has built for himself since then. Coming in at number 4 is Sally Field. She is a 2-time Academy Award winner who played Aunt May in both 2012's The Amazing Spider-Man and also the 2014 sequel. However, the actress has agreed with some fans and critics that the reboots are pointless. She first said in an interview that these movies wouldn't usually be her sort of movie. She took a chance on the role, but she found it very hard to find a 3-dimensional character in the script she was given to work with. She went even further during an interview where she admitted she only did the movies as a favor to her friend, the producer Laura Siskin. Ouch, looks like she won't be doing any more favors for Marvel by sticking around then. Alright guys, at number 3 we have Nicolas Cage, a very successful actor even outside the MCU. It was his role in Ghost Rider that had fans believing he would slay the role of being a badass stunt motorcyclist Johnny Blaze. The first film received a lot of negative reviews, and the second one earned Nicolas a Razzie nomination for Worst Actor, while the film also was nominated as Worst Remake. It's safe to say there won't be a third movie, not just because it wasn't a success, but because Cage doesn't want to return for it anyways. He admitted, and I quote, "I think the ship has sailed with that one, at least with me involved." Don't worry, we also think that ship has sailed too, and it seems like Marvel agrees with us. They've moved on to bigger and better things. No offense, Nicolas Cage. Alright guys, at number 3 we have Tom Cruise. It was a very popular headline at the time that the actor was number 1 in line to play MCU's Tony Stark in Iron Man. The action star has been attached to the role in some way since the early 1990s, way before the MCU even got off the ground. Marvel approached Cruise with the role when it first decided to make Iron Man, which was the first movie in the cinematic universe, so kind of a big deal. Turns out Cruise changed his mind about the role and turned down the offer. If he would have taken the role, it would have made him co-producer as well, but he said he declined it because he didn't like where the script ended up. During a 2016 appearance on Jimmy Kimmel Live, he confessed that he likes comic book movies but is content just making Mission Impossible films. The MCU moved forward without him, and he did the same. Seems like there's no bad blood between the two universes, but it's clear that Marvel can't count on Cruise for future roles, and Cruise doesn't seem to want them anyways. Alright guys, at number 3 we have Henry Cavill, also known as Superman from the DCU. Everyone knows the rule of thumb that DC actors can't be in Marvel movies and vice versa. Although the two universes are not in competition with each other, it's just a rule when it comes to casting. Which sucks for actors because they ultimately have to pick their universe and stick with it. And Henry has done just that. No hard feelings for him taking on the role of Superman, but now Marvel won't hire him. Which might be an okay thing because there has been a lot of controversy about rumors stating Henry is leaving his role as Superman. He has played the iconic character in 3 DC comic movies already and was supposed to make a cameo in the recent Shazam movie, but scheduling conflicts prevented him from making an appearance. The rumors that he was leaving the franchise have spiraled out of control on the internet, and he simply responded with an Instagram video that has him staring into the camera as he slowly brings up a Superman figurine into the frame and then moves it out again. Which you could imagine just made the fans go absolutely mental. Is he staying? Is he leaving? Which is it? Marvel doesn't have time for those kinds of games, and even if Henry wanted to, he doesn't have time for Marvel. He's still locked in with the DCU and also just signed onto another franchise called The Witcher. So he's a pretty busy man with some pretty big franchise obligations. At number two, we have Jessica Alba. She's known for a number of different movies, but it was Fantastic Four Ride of the Silver Surfer that she claims made her want to stop acting. During an interview, she was recalling her time while working with Tim Story. She said he often questioned her performance by asking things like, "Can you be prettier when you cry?" And that was when Alba knew she didn't care about the industry anymore. The movie ended up getting a reputation of being one of the worst rebooted franchises, only receiving a 37% on Rotten Tomatoes. Jessica Alba has actually put a hold on her acting career and says that she really stopped acting when she was 27 years old. She's now focusing on her family and the business side of the career. With the way she spoke about the director Tom Story, I don't think any director is too thrilled to work with her again, especially another Marvel movie. Taking over the number two spot is Ronda Rousey. Yes, the former UFC champion. It took the MCU a long time to give one of its female heroes her own movie, and when they did, Ronda wanted the part. When Marvel announced that Captain Marvel would be getting her own movie, everyone was thrilled and speculations on the casting began immediately. A number of different actresses came forward offering their skills and talent, but no one was as vocal as this UFC fighter who claimed she wanted the role more than anyone. She began talking about it early on in 2015 and put a lot of effort into campaigning herself for the role. Her fans helped her out by creating fan art with her in the Captain Marvel suit. The online buzz she was creating was so big that it got back to Marvel's president Kevin Feige, who said he really liked all the fan art he saw. When asked about Ronda taking on the role, he admitted that they often go through actors bulking up and taking on the superhero role versus someone like a wrestler who you chance on being an amazing performer. Although he liked the buzz his movie was getting by all of Ronda's fan art, she wasn't actually considered for the role. Let's face it, she's not an actor. She's made some small appearances in The Expendables 3, Furious 7, and Entourage, but hasn't always received positive feedback for her acting skills. She's always been known as the badass UFC fighter with a short temper, and some fans say she should stick to fighting. Once the casting took place, reports say that Ronda had a temper with not getting the role and didn't want to comment on the subject when asked about it in interviews. Being a poor sport just gives Marvel more reason not to consider her for other future roles. At number two, we have Hugo Weaving, also known for his epic role of the Red Skull in the MCU. In 2011, Captain America: The First Avenger was a huge success and followed the story of Steve Rogers being exposed to an experimental treatment that turned him into a superhero. But the movie wouldn't be complete without his arch enemy, the Red Skull. Critics raved about his performance and so did his fans, but Weaving wasn't as thrilled about it. In interviews, the actor has said flat out that not only is he not returning for his role of Red Skull, but that he would never work on a Marvel movie again. He said it in a graceful way, but he said he only wants to do movies he has a personal connection to. Well, fair enough, I guess. Alright guys, at number two we have Jim Carrey. The incredibly successful actor starred in Kick-Ass 2, which was a movie based on a comic published by Marvel imprint Icon. The story was a violent action-packed movie just like the first one. However, Carrey made the decision to withdraw his public support from the movie in the lead up to its release after the Sandy Hook Elementary School massacre in 2012. The actor said he is a passionate advocate of gun control and wouldn't support the movie's violence. Although some fans respected him for the decision, John Romita Jr., the artist of the comics, saw things differently. He criticized Jim for cashing the large paycheck he got from the movie before he jeopardized the earning potential of the crew and other cast who worked really hard on the film. He even went as far to say that Carrey should be ashamed of himself. I can respect Jim Carrey's decision personally, and knowing the violence in the Marvel movies we see today, he probably won't be hired anytime soon simply for that reason. Taking the number one spot on our list is Terrence Howard. He is known as the actor whose role as James Rhodey Rhodes was given to another actor, Don Cheadle. But that isn't just it, it's the reason why the switch happened. Apparently Howard wasn't pleased with the suggested pay cut for starring in the Iron Man sequel. During an interview on Watch What Happens Live, he called out his co-star Robert Downey Jr. for stealing his spotlight. He said, and I quote, "It turns out that the person I helped become Iron Man, when it was time to re-up for the second one, he took the money that was supposed to go to me and pushed me out." He also went on to say that Marvel executives said this sequel will be successful with or without him, and offered to pay him 1/8 of his original salary. Howard still remains bitter, but has moved on with his acting career. I think it's best that Marvel just moves on too. Taking our number one spot is Matthew Matthew McConaughey. We can't even be surprised to find out that the successful actor has gotten scripts from both Marvel and DC. In October 2015, Variety reported that McConaughey passed on a major Marvel role. This had fans wondering how he could possibly turn down an offer like that. Later on in January 2017, he told Playboy why he said no to Ego the Living Planet, and he said, I quote, "I like Guardians of the Galaxy, but what I saw was, it's successful and now we've gotten room to make a colorful part for another big name actor. I'd feel like an amendment." Okay then, so it seems like the big name actor thinks he's too good for the film and that they were just trying to use his success for their benefits. I think Marvel is aware of their own success and won't be offering anything else to him in the future. Taking our number one spot is David Hasselhoff, who once took on the role as Nick Fury in a terrible movie back in 1988. The movie has been labeled as atrocious, but Hasselhoff seems to think differently. To this day, he still raves about how he was the original Nick Fury and that he was the best one to do it. During an interview, he stated, and I quote, "I love Sam Jackson, but you know, my Nick Fury was the organic Nick Fury that was written and discussed with Stan Lee before anyone got in there and changed it. Nick Fury was written to be tongue-in-cheek and he had a cigar in his mouth. He was a tough guy. He was cool." I doubt the MCU fans would agree that Hasselhoff's version of Nick Fury would have been a better choice for the Avengers over Samuel L. Jackson's newer version. Not to mention, he probably wouldn't be welcome back into the MCU anyways with the new reputation he has going for himself. He's been in a number of different scandals, more recently known for the drunk videos his daughter has posted on the internet, which has caused a lot of controversy. Let's just leave Nick Fury with Jackson and Hufflepuff, Hasselhoff, whatever, can be on his way. Taking our number one spot is Jamie Foxx. The actor is known for many things: acting, singing, songwriting, being a comedian, and also a record producer. But one thing he's also known for is sexually assaulting women. The actor has the look, the success, and the muscles to take on a role in the MCU, but his reputation would never allow it at this point. The actor has been caught up in a variety of different scandals, with allegations against him for sexual assault. In 2018, a woman came forward saying that Jamie Foxx sexually assaulted her by slapping her with his penis back in 2002. She went on to say that the incident happened at his home in Las Vegas when she and a friend were attending his house party. She claims that Foxx tried to get her to perform oral sex by forcing himself upon her, and when she refused, he struck her in the face with his penis. His lawyer is now fighting the allegations by saying, "Hitting someone in the face with your penis isn't considered sexual assault in Nevada." Whether the allegation is true or not, the actor, who could have done well in the MCU, especially with black actors now being so involved, won't even get the chance.